Dear students, now we are going to discuss about the story Avance Tries an O-Level. Introduction. This story was written by Norman Colin Dexter. He was an English crime writer and he was known for his Inspector Morse series of novels. This story, Avance Tries an O-Level, about a cunning prisoner, Avance, who makes a plan to escape from the prison on the day of his German language O-level exam. Characters. Here there are a few important characters of this story. James Roderick Evans. He was a prisoner and secretary of the examination board. Governor. The governor of HM Prison, Oxford. And Mr. Jackson, senior prison officer. And Stephens, a prison officer. And Reverend Stuart McCleary, he was an invigilator. And Mr. Carter, a detective superintendent. And Mr. Bell, a detective chief inspector. So they are the important characters of this story. This story starts with a telephonic conversation between the governor and the examination board secretary. So the prison authorities want to conduct an O-level exam in German language for a prisoner named Evans. So the secretary of the examination board asks about the venue of the exam and also about the invigilator for it. The governor replies that the exam can be conducted in Evans' cell and a churchman will be appointed as the invigilator for the exam. So, senior prison official Jackson visits Avon's cell to conduct an inspection so that if any weapon may be hidden. So, they are going through this checking because Avon's had successfully escaped from the prison earlier. So, this episode gave him a name of Avon's the Break because already he was escaped from the prison 3 times. As he was escaped from the prison earlier, the governor was not ready to take any risk with this. So it could bring a bad name to him. So Jackson and Stephens checked the cell thoroughly. They had taken away his nail scissors earlier and Jackson, senior prison officer, orders Stephens to take away his razor blade as soon as he saved. And Jackson ordered to take off his hat, but Evans refused to remove his hat. And Evans requested him not to do so as it was his lucky hat for the exam. So all sort of arrangements were made to keep a check on Evans. Even a microphone was placed in his cell on the day of exam. On the day of exam, McCleary, he was an invigilator, churchman, reached the prison and he was assisted to the cell by Stephens, junior prison officer. The governor was informed that the exam was about to begin and that the cell did not have any weapons. The governor ordered the officer to check the churchman so that Evans may not use any property of McCleary as a weapon. The churchman and his belongings were searched. The paper knife was also removed so that Evans might not use it. So during the search, Jackson found one abnormal thing in the churchman's bag. It was a semi-filled tube. So when asked the reason for keeping it, McCleary said that he had to use it as he suffered from piles. So after the search, the examination begins and everything was going according to the plan. Meanwhile, a phone call from the examination board for some corrections in question paper. It made the governor suspicious. So governor want to cross check So he called the number again, but it was busy. The governor was sure about his arrangements, and Stephens, junior prisoner, stood outside of the cell and peeped inside after every minute. It was always the same, but later on he noticed, Stephens noticed, that Evans had put up a blanket around himself. Though he doubted, but the first then stopped thinking much, as it was cold inside the cell. So after the exam, as per the governor order, Stephens accompanies McCleary to the gate. So everything went as planned, and Stephens was happy. So even though he wanted to be sure of himself, so once again he went to the cell for a final look. He was shocked to see McCleary lying in a pool of blood. Soon the news was spread. That Evans had injured the invigilator and escaped from the jail. McCleary, who was badly injured, was taken to the governor as he had some important information. McCleary told the governor about the photography being placed on the question paper, which shared the escape plan with Evans. The governor tried to decode the German language and found out that Evans would reach Newbury after his escape. Soon, the superintendent Carter was called, and McCleary was sent with him to catch Evans. Both Jackson and Stephens were scolded for being unaware about Evans having a false beard and the churchman's belongings in his cell. Then the governor ordered both Stephens and Jackson to go to Stain Aldate's police station and meet Chief Inspector Bell. Meanwhile, Carter called him up to inform that they have missed Evans while chasing him. So, and the injured McCleary was sent to Radcliffe Hospital for treatment. The governor called up the hospital and came to know that they had sent an ambulance to the examination board, but the churchman had already disappeared. Now the governor understood the whole plan, that McCleary, who was helping to search Evans, was in fact Evans himself. And soon the real McCleary was also found by the police, who was tied up at his house. On the other hand, Evans had reached Hotel Gold Line and was everything, and he was enjoying his freedom. So Evans, when he reached hotel room, he found governor in his room. He told Evans that he had all governor told Evans that he had all of his men around, so there was no chance for him from escape again. The governor asked him about his plan, and Evans told every bit of it to him. Finally, the prison van was called to take Evans to the prison from the hotel. The governor felt proud of catching him again. And as soon as the van started, the prison officer unlocked Evans' handcuffs and asked the driver to drive fast. So finally, once again, Evans managed to escape from the clutches of the police with the help of his friends. So finally, Evans again, he befools the governor. Both prison officer and the prison van were part of the plan devised by Evans' friends. And this is what about the story, Evans tries on a O level. I hope you all understand. Thank you, children.